Okay, today we will continue with our discussion on special electromechanical systems. So today we will also review the different types of special machines with reference to conventional machines, and also some typical application scenario. Okay, that's what we will do in today's lecture. So, you are aware that a classification of machines, they are conventional, they are the DC machine, they are the AC synchronous machines, AC asynchronous are induction machines. Okay. These are known to you. Okay. I hope you know, because DC machine, they take a DC supply, these two take AC supply. Okay. Then you have the stepper motor, which takes a pulsar supply, okay, and the switched reluctance motor also sort of a pulse supply, but at higher frequency. Okay. Then the other classification, disc and printed motors. The disc motors are basically not a conventional type of a cylindrical. So, they are conductors are placed on discs in a radial fashion, and magnets are placed for producing a flux which is parallel to the shaft. Okay. Then the linear motors, which are again spread out machine, which gives you a linear motion, not a rotary motion. Okay. Now, you understand that these two are of a different type, right? In terms of construction and working, and while these four are of a classical construction of a cylindrical construction. Okay. So, there is, so you find the broad differences in the configuration. You see, the most of the machines, you have a stator, rotor and shaft. Okay. So, you have the fluxes going like this, is not it? And you have the currents which are located. So, the currents will be going in perpendicular to the board. Okay. Whereas, disc machine, this is the conventional cylindrical, right. In a disc machine, what they have is, you can have magnets pasted on this. Okay. There can be a return path also, or it could be a return. So, you will have a the conductors may be radial like this. Okay. If you look it from the side, so you will find that the conductors are all wound like this on a farmer or something like that. Okay. So, this is the disc type. Okay. So, you will notice that the flux lines will be like this. Is it okay? Have you understood? So, the flux lines will be like this, but this may be the, there may be a shaft here. So, this will be rotating type of thing. And if you look at the linear machine, so linear machine, so you will have a picture like this. So, this is the rotor, this is the stator. So, this will move. So, there could be, if you have a induction motor, linear induction motor, so this can be a, this can be the three phase windings, and this could be a sort of a squirrel cage, bars placed like this. So, this is one of the things which are used in magnetic levitated trains and things. So, any rotary thing can be just cut it and spread it out. That is typically what you can conceive as. Is it okay? As a constructions of the three classification of the machine. So, they are all special type of configurations. Now, the DC machines, you are aware that there is a wound field motors which are conventional, where you have the poles on the stator having windings where you pass the currents. Okay. Then instead of that, then you can have permanent magnet motors. Okay. Instead of the wound field, you have the permanent magnet placed there, or you can have hybrid motors where you can have both the wound field and PM. So, you have a total configuration. And your other one is a brushless motor, which will be inverted motor. Your magnet is in the rotor and the stator excitation is such that it is always at quadrature with the magnetic field. Okay. So, you have a DC excitation. Of course, DC motors can also be servo motors. Right. And then of course, there are micro motors also pass as part of the DC motor. They are small motors. Micro motors they are called because they are very small motors of that configuration. For DC generators, you are aware of the same thing where you run it to get a DC supply. But nowadays, there are very limited use of DC generators. Okay. Then synchronous machines, we have the conventional wound field. Rotor has the magnetic electromagnet. So, wound field motors, permanent magnet motors, instead of wound field, the permanent magnet. Here the supply is always sinusoidal three phase on the stator side, unlike a brushless DC. So, you must always make a difference between a brushless DC machine and a PM synchronous machine. Okay, these two are slightly different, though the configuration appears to be similar. Okay. Then we have what is a reluctance motor. You know what is known as a reluctance torque, right? If you have a salient pole rotor, even if the field excitation is zero, you are told that there is a if you have a variable reluctance, this can be a reluctance stator, of course, will be similar. Stator is three phase. So, even if the field current is zero, you know there is a torque that is produced versus the delta, and that will have a 0 to pi. Okay. So, this will have a torque angle which is twice sin theta. Okay. So, the torque of the reluctance will be some constant times sin 2 delta or something. Okay. So, this is a reluctance torque. So, you can work it as a reluctance motor even if there is no field winding excited or with no field winding at all. So, this is called a, this is a synchronous machine, it runs only at synchronous speed. Okay. Then we have hysteresis motor. In this hysteresis motor, you have the rotor is made up of hysteresis material. So, this has a hysteresis material. So, as a rotating field is produced, it has a magnetic field created. So, it becomes like a induced permanent magnet, because it can conserve the magnetic field. That is what the question of hysteresis is. So, this becomes, and accordingly when this will now be in line with the inducing field and that will produce a torque. That is called a hysteresis motor. Okay. Then there are the eddy current motors. I mean, it is also like rotor again induce currents instead of fields. They are of course, very special. You see, even your energy meter is like eddy current, conventional energy meters. You know, you induce currents in an aluminum disc, isn't it? That is also eddy current motor. Then synchronous generators, reverse of the motor, they are wound field feeding to the grid. They are also permanent magnet generators. They are nowadays thinking of for windmills, etcetera. The generators are permanent magnet rotor, and there are self-excited generators or brushless generators. I mean, that means excitation is given by the supply, by the induced stator, you rectify it and so on. So, they are brushless generators. Okay, then of course, induction machines or asynchronous machines, you are aware, the conventional three phase induction motors. I hope you are aware of the construction, stator has three phase. There is one is a slip ring rotor. Rotor is having again a wound three phase windings. Okay. So, this will become a doubly fed. You can feed power both from the stator and the rotor. So, it is called a doubly fed. Of course, other is a squirrel cage induction motor. Rotor is a squirrel cage. Okay. They are all short circuited. Then of course, generators, same thing can work as induction generator when once you make the slip greater than or slip negative or speed greater than 1. So, then you have it will produce a power which is negative, the R feeds power to the grid. Now, these are nowadays as I told you have been used for feeding for the wind energy systems. So, these are grid current induction generator. So, they are connected to the grid connected induction generators. So, when you get power from the prime mover, it is now converted and fed to the mains. So, there are again two types, squirrel cage which have been used. Nowadays, they are thinking of doubly fed induction generators. So, that means you can have a power fed through the slip rings also to the rotor. So, these are the new type of applications or technology which are coming up, and also they are interfaced with the power electronic circuits which should provide lot of controllability in the performance. Then another thing is the self excited induction generators where your excitation is given by a capacitor, reactive power is given by the capacitor, right, and you do not need the grid. So, this will be grid independent self excited. So, these are the areas we are looking at. Then in this variety we have the single phase induction motors. So, the single phase induction motors are the largest, one of the very large number of fractional kilowatt machines produced. Okay. You find them, every house has at least about 8-10 single phase motors. Okay. Now, they do not have a starting torque. So, there are types called split phase induction motors. They are basically two windings are there. Rotor is always squirrel cage. In all the single phase motors, rotor is always squirrel cage, but the stator has invariably two windings, one basically starting winding, another is for the running winding. So, the split phase, of course, we will discuss it in detail when we go into the single phase induction motor theory, etcetera. And you use capacitor start motors, and or you have permanent capacitor motors, or two value are capacitor start, capacitor run motors. And you also have shaded pole motors. Shaded pole motors are typically, you know, sewing machines and things, what they are, small table fans. Table fans invariably have shaded pole motors. Okay. Then you have the AC servo motors. So, these are the classification of single phase motors. Okay. So, typically you will have two windings, we call it the main winding or auxiliary winding. Okay. Rotor is squirrel cage and you have the single phase supply. So, invariably you connect both of them. Right, main and auxiliary winding. Now, in the split phase, these two are with no capacitors, but if you have a capacitor there, then you add a capacitor in the auxiliary winding. Okay. And if you have only capacitor start, you have a switch also. Switch will get opened when it runs to near the rated speed, or you can have another capacitor. So, you can have another capacitor which again is another switch. So, you have a start capacitor or a run capacitor. Okay. So, you have one or two capacitors. Capacitor either can be permanently there as in a ceiling fan, or capacitor can be disconnected as a capacitor start machine, or you can have two capacitors, one to start, another to run. So these are the variants, and this is the induction machine. This is the standard single phase induction motor. Now in the sort of the shaded pole, you have a shading ring here. Okay, of course, rotor is squirrel cage. So you have a shading ring, you have the poles. So you have two, you have another shading ring here. That means you have just to start a induced current is there in the shading coil, which will be other than the main winding. So there will be a phase shift between the current in the main winding and the shaded winding. So that is enough to start. All you need is to spin it at starting. Okay. And of course, AC servo motor are used in many of the communication and power applications, where it has to start. Supposing it gets, as soon as it gets a signal, then only it will start. Okay. And this is typically you have the main winding and you have the auxiliary winding, and this is always connected in a servo motor. But here this VA, this is only when you want to start, only the VA will come, otherwise it will not be there. So supposing you want to open a circuit breaker, okay, or you want to move a radar towards the target or whatever it is. So these are called, the servo motor will only operate whenever you require the movement. Okay, this is the servo motor. This is permanently connected, and this, as soon as this gets a signal, only it will move. So this is the servo motor. Okay, then of course you must have seen the universal motor, which works on DC and AC. That is why it is called a universal motor. This is typically a AC series motor, a series commutator motor. So you know the DC series motor, you apply the AC, it will become this. So these are all high speed motors, which are typically used in your mixers, grinders, drilling machines and so on, wherever you have the high speed. And they are also used for electric traction. Some of the, in Switzerland, they are still using universal motors of a low frequency, like that 50 by 3 or so is the frequency, etc. Okay. Now, other one is the stepper motors. Stepper motor broadly has they move in steps, and typically, if you have a, let us say some coils like this, let us say A, B, C, D magnets with coils over it, then if you place some rotor like this. So if A is excited, it will come here. If B is excited, it will come here. If C is excited, it will come here. And if D is excited, it will go here, isn't it? So if you switch the coils in a sequence A, B, C, D, then you expect the rotor to go on moving in steps. I am just giving a simplest example. This is a basic principle of a stepper motor. So you can make it here, it could be a just a bar or a variable reluctance, or it could be a magnet also. Okay. So it will be varying. So they move in steps. Okay. Supposing a variac has to be moved up to vary the voltage. So it can be coupled to a stepper motor to vary the handle like that. Okay. So there are rotor, it can be permanent magnet, or rotor can be variable reluctance, just iron piece variable reluctance, or it can be combination of both PM and variable reluctance. Okay. Well, you can also think of a shaded pole stepper motor as another variety. Okay. Then lastly, we have the linear motors. So whatever that linear motor you can assume to be the base, the rotary motors which have been cut and spread out, okay, cut and spread out, it becomes linear motor. You can create a linear induction motor, right, where one will be squirrel cage, another will be a three phase system. You can have a linear synchronous motor where one could be permanent magnet or a wound field, another could be a three phase system. A linear reluctance motor where one would be a three phase AC supply, another could be a variable reluctance, okay, that can also move. Because just like a rotary motion, the rotor will follow the induced rotating field in the air gap, is not it? There is a rotating field in there. Here it is not a rotating field. What type of field is it? It is a traveling field, it is moving. Okay. So, as it moves, the rotor, now it is not, you can say rotor is a little misnomer here, so or a moving member. Okay. So, that will follow the field which is produced by the stationary member. Okay. You can have linear stepper motor also. Stepper motor also can be linear. You can have a linear permanent magnet motors. Okay. So, you can have whatever is rotor. Rotary type of machines can always be conceived to have a linear motion, okay, by appropriate modification of construction and winding dispositions. Okay. Now, one thing now we will see, why is it that these special machines have now come? What are the factors which are responsible for this? Okay. One factor is that the development of new materials, for there have always been the research in material science has created new materials. Another factor is the switching systems. Nowadays it is possible, you can do lot of soft switchings, the invent lot of developments in power electronics, power modules, then softwares, microcontrollers, DSP. So, you can do lot of programming, so that you can switch the devices in a very elegant fashion. And another thing is there have been need of new applications. These are the three major factors which has led to the development of new and special machines. Okay. Now, new materials, right? For example, one of the material is the ferrite magnets, which has a combination of iron and oxide and this strontium carbonate, etc. There are what are plastic magnets. Okay. They are chemical combination of this thing. There are the Alnico magnets, okay, and the latest magnetic material which high density is Sumerian cobalt, as well as the neodymium iron boron. This is a very high density magnet. Okay. The characteristics, you know, in permanent magnets, basically which side of the BH loop you will work, see. You have the BH loop, is not it, right? Which side you will, which portion of this works as a permanent magnet? Which portion? Here, is not it? So, it is basically in this portion, so it is this portion which works as a magnet, because in this case your H is negative and B is positive. Right. So, even if you do not apply, you are having a negative magnetic field intensity to produce the flux. So, you do not have, so it is a negative electromagnet. So, now this is the portion in which it will be operating. Okay. Now, this portion, that means when there is a 0 B, there is a B here, and this is like open circuit. And this is like a short circuit. Okay. Now, it can operate in any one of these points, and B into H gives you the energy density, is not it? Okay. Here energy is how much? What is the energy here if you operate at this point? 0. Here? 0. Therefore, you will operate somewhere here where you can get some maximum BH, right? And so, BH will tell you the characteristic. Now, if you have, let us say you have one material which has this BH and another material with this BH, which one has a better energy? Upper one, is not it? So, there are several materials. So, this may be ferrite and this may be neodymium, iron, boron. So, which has a higher one, which is even 100 times. So, there are in between all nico, various materials are there. So, manufacturers will tell you. So, there are several materials will have a several characteristics like this. Okay. So, depending upon what material you use, you can have a better design of the motor. Okay. So, the materials have led to this. Of course, nowadays there are better insulating materials. You know, they are, for a machine consists of different materials, conducting materials, magnetic materials, insulating materials, cooling materials, and then even the shafts, the bearings. Okay. And you must all understand that the electromechanical systems will have both electrical and mechanical. Therefore, electrical engineers have as much as say or more or less compared to mechanical engineers, okay, depending upon the industry. Okay. Therefore, you need to know on the mechanical aspects also. Okay. So, there are these materials, you know, feature of these materials, the high retentivity, high coercive strength, high energy density, as it were BH is more, and they are available in a large magnetic range, you go to higher capacities, and they are now again machinability of the magnet materials are also important. Guys, how do you create a permanent magnet? You have to take the material and magnetize it. You have to have a magnetizing, you must pass a very high current over it, and then so that it retains the magnetism. Okay. So, there are several ways of doing it. One is you ask the manufacturers to magnetize and send you the magnet of a proper shape, or you first cut it to a proper shape and then magnetize it yourself. So, both are being tried, and so the machinability of this will be important. In fact, some of the magnets are so powerful, if you hold it in your hand, your watch may get damaged, the magnetic fields are high. Okay. Or it may damage, you know, if you do not hold it properly, it may hurt you also. Okay. It may hit you on the ceilings if there is an iron piece on the ceiling. So, there are several factors are there. Okay. Therefore, and you can also make any size and shape, and you have a high Curie point temperatures. Okay. Then there are switching mechanism. Now, you can have high speed switching devices are possible. You have very good devices which can go for high speed switching. Then their availability at low cost and reduced cost of switching and power control systems. So, these are the ones which are now factors responsible, and you can control them, easy control mechanisms, and digital control nowadays is possible through DSPs or microcontrollers. So, that is one of the factors which are responsible for this. And you can also have a remote control, or you can also think of online sensing. I mean, nowadays you can have the optical type of controls that are possible. Okay. Therefore, these are the things which are, after all, when they are used to space applications and so on, you need to have sophistication in controls. Okay. Okay. On what are the applications? We thought, you know, I have classified the different type of applications of these. Okay. In industry, the machines, the motors are used for what? Broadly, industrial drives. Okay. The pumps, blowers, compressors, centrifuges, okay, and fans, the milling, hoists, handling systems and so on. So, if you look at industry, there are a lot of such things are there, even punching. Okay. So, their industrial drives have very many applications like this. And you have machine tools. Okay. Machine tool industry in the motors are used, okay, for lathes, milling machines and various this thing, CNC machine. And you also have servo drives. Servo drives are, as I told you, more torque producing, not the power producing. Okay. Then what, where the motors are used in public life, okay, like air conditioners. Air conditioners, they use motors, okay, and different types of motors are being, you know, presently single phase induction motors have been used. Maybe they are thinking of even three phase induction motor with inverter, and also variable speed drives and permanent magnet drives. So, they all are coming up. The catering equipment, many conveyors, etcetera, big canteens and so on, clocks, amusement you have in public life. You have motors everywhere, ATMs. There are motors within your, before you, when you take your money in the machine, something moves there, isn't it? So it's all, it has to be just operated by your card, right? You must see how, whatever sophistication, etc. Okay, ticketing machines. They also use special machines inside. These are barcode readers. So they are all in general public life, okay, where you deal with. Then domestic, okay. Domestic you have all over, you know, like kitchen equipment, refrigerators, microwave ovens, food mixers, they all use motors, okay. Then your bathroom equipment, you need motors, okay. Then washing machines, you need motors. You need motors whenever you have room heaters, heating, okay, air conditioners, fans. So weather control, you need motors, okay. Lawn mowers use motors, toys, okay. Then you have entertainment like vision equipment, sound equipment like your DVDs, TV, music systems, they all have motors, okay, of different types wherever you have the effect motion. And you have motors for security systems. Supposing your automatic opening, closure of doors. In India it is perhaps less in use, but in industrialized countries security system has become very important. Okay. And of course, here also in many of the industries or high security zones, defense applications, you need these. So, these are all the ones which are used. Then IT and office equipment. So, you have the computers, you have lot of motors over there, you have printers, plotters, scanners, copiers and audio visual aids like LCD projectors, okay. Your fax machines and floppy and DVD drives, CPU fans, hard disk drives. So, you have all these equipment, office equipment, the motors everywhere. Then automobiles and combustion engines. So nowadays you use lot of motors in automobiles, okay, in this way. Then transportation. So that is area where you have electric traction, electric trains, you need motors, okay. Not only in the main drive motor, there are many motors within the trains, okay. The fans in compartments or air conditioners, or even fuel pumps, lubricants. So, there are many auxiliary motors are also in an engine, not just only the drive motor, okay. Then you have elevators and escalators, they have the motors, okay. The lifts, okay, lifts and elevators. The escalator, you know, it is different, okay. Then light railways, trams, etc., they use motors. You have electric vehicles and hybrid vehicles, again you have the motors, okay. Then electric ships, in fact the most of the ships power is through a generator, but there are several machines which are going there in the ship. You have aircraft control, the many controls in the aircraft are electrical and many motors are there for control. Nowadays it is getting more electric. Earlier it was more pneumatic controls, okay. So that is one thing which requires these applications. Then you have the surface actuation, because when the aircraft is on the is landed, again you need lot of movements, okay. There you require some motors, right. Even the, for example, if you have this the bridges, you know, when you connect to the terminal to the aircraft, okay. So they all have to move, right? So there are motors for this purpose, okay. Okay. Then the boats, they also have motors in transportation. So you have battery driven vehicles, and power windows, motor engine fans. So, they are all part of the transportation. So, you can imagine the various types of motors and the controls and the whole mechanism which is going to this. Okay. Defense, you have motors in the tanks, because the Arjun tank is yet to come from India, but you know, but then there are a lot of motors over there. There are motors in missiles, the radar, submarines, torpedoes. Okay. So, there will be various types of motors over there. Aerospace are space applications. Okay. Your rockets, large number of motors are there, and even satellites. Satellites also, there are motors which are to orient the satellite to appropriate directions of to collect the power from the sun. So, there are also motors are there. Space shuttles, you have large number of motors, and solar array drives. Okay. And antenna drives, because communication equipment has to be moved to appropriate directions. So, they are all you can imagine a lot of sophisticated involved. You have medical and healthcare. Nowadays, medical healthcare is becoming more and more technological. Okay. So, you have dentist drills, electric wheelchairs, rehabilitation equipment, okay. Then artificial heart motors, biomedical instruments, you have CT scans, you know, you name it, you know, there are motors, okay, where there are movements which take place. Okay. So, it's a wide variety of equipment which you go there. Power tools, you have drills, hammers, grinders, polishers, saws, screwdrivers, robotic arms, unmanned machine tools. Okay. So, they are all, you have motors in all these tools which are there. Okay. Then renewable energy. Now, that is one new area which has opened up. So, you have lot of various types of generators and motors. For example, if you solar PV, if you want to use the solar energy, if you want to have a pump to be operated by solar panels, so you have a different type of motor. Wind energy, you require different types of generators. Okay. Small hydro, you require different type of generators and controls. Biomass energy also you require different type of control. So, you have mini hydro systems or generation in self grid current induction generator, it is feeding to the grid or stand alone. You have captive generation or rural electrification, okay, using this self external induction generator. So, you can think of permanent magnet generator. You can think of, nowadays they are talking micro turbines. Micro turbines are almost running at 60,000 RPM. Okay. Run by the same engine. So, if there is a generator which will run at 60,000 RPM, what type of generator you need to have? Okay. You can have a permanent magnet generator, but that will be producing voltage at very high frequencies. So, you need to have a rectifier and inverter system. So, whole gamut of renewable energy or non-conventional energy is being thought of as an application of special machines, or special machines will evolve out of these things. So, you will see all these developments have taken place because of the needs. Okay. Of course, these things we are going to discuss in detail. Maybe I need not go into this. PMDC commutator motors. Okay, these are the normal DC machines with commutators. Then PM brushless motors, where you don't have a mechanical commutator, you have electronic commutator. You do the commutation the stator side, not on the rotor side. Okay, so which will give a high torque range, etcetera. Okay, then. Okay, these are the printed circuit motors, what you see here. So, you have the, you can see the circuits are printed over here, and these are the magnets here. Okay. So, this will be the armature. Is it clear? Right. So, this will, interaction of these currents with this magnetic field will produce a torque over this. So, this is the shaft. So, this is axial flux and radial armature conductor mounted on shaft. Okay. So, this is the printer circuit and or a disc motors, what it is called. Okay. So it is a complex structure, low inertia, it is a low inertia, okay, because of light, this thing. You have a low torque ripples and modest efficiency, very, very small size. These are used for many applications where you require a larger radius or diameter. Okay. So these are some applications of PMDC motors, electronic computer industry, automobile industry, domestic applications, vacuum cleaners, battery driven vehicles, etcetera. Okay. These are the floppy drives, most of the computer drives have permanent magnet motor magnet. Okay. Then permanent magnet synchronous motors, again the only difference is the sinusoidal supplies. Okay. So it is PM synchronous motor is an induction where air gap field is produced by the permanent magnet. Okay. So PM synchronous motor is electric machine, three phase stator, and the rotor has a surface mounted magnets. Okay. On the surface of the rotor you paste the magnets. Okay. So PM synchronous motor, these are features, you know, high reliability. We will discuss this in detail when you go to these machines. Okay. These are applications of these permanent, you have used automotives, refrigerators, servo drives, power steering. So you can have permanent magnet synchronous motors. So permanent synchronous motors are all constant speed motors, right? Because you apply a constant speed, constant frequency supply to this thing. Okay. Then of course reluctance motor is basically a rotor is a variable reluctance. Okay. Okay. Then that means you can make, you know, you need to remove some tooth. Say most of the machines have a rotor have a uniform tooth. If you remove some tooth, it becomes variable reluctance. Just like, you know, after aging people get, you know, the tooth, so they become variable reluctance tooth. Okay. Okay. Right. So you have a otherwise it is a smooth uniform tooth, right. So now this starts as an induction motor but runs as a synchronous motor. Okay. You can have you can put some bars into the rotor. So it, there is a starting torque and then this can be worked as reluctance motors. Okay. These are highly precise speed, low power factor, efficient in low power region. Okay. And they are used in timing devices, phonograph, turntable, signaling devices, recording instruments, etcetera. Wherever you need a constant speed, these reluctance motors have been in use. Okay. Hysteresis motor, it is a synchronous motor with uniform gap but with no DC excitation. Okay. Effect of hysteresis, the magnetization developed in the material in the rotor, okay, which lacks the, so rotor field is lagging the stator field because of the magnetic hysteresis. So it will create a magnetic field. So rotor is made of material having high retentivity and permeability and have a large hysteresis loop. Okay. So there is hysteresis effect. Okay. So these are used in driving high inertia loads, precision audio equipment and military applications. Because in fact the ISRO have been using these hysteresis motors for their space applications, etcetera. So there are no mechanical vibrations, uniform torque and quiet and smooth operation. But the three phase induction motors you are aware of, I do not think we need to, is a well known machine. Okay. And its stator rotor is known, I do not think we know. Okay. And the features of three phase induction motor, high reliability, medium efficiency, low starting, high starting torque, no electromagnetic interference, low cost per horsepower, etcetera. I think these are all there. I think you can, these are basically a comparison of different type of motors in terms of features. Okay. Of course, induction motors, you know, are used as in electric drives, compressors, air conditioner, pumps and washing. Several applications are induction motor. Mainly they are used in near constant speed applications where pumps, blowers, compressors, fans, okay, and so on. Okay. Then single phase motors is the same three phase motor with single phase supplies, but it does not have a starting torque. You have to create a starting mechanism. Okay. A single phase is a rotating machine, both main and auxiliary windings, and of course rotor is squirrel cage. Okay. So, you have split phase, capacitor start, capacitor run and two capacitors. So, it can be used as single phase motor or a two phase motor, okay. You can even have a two phase supply, right. Then they are highly reliable, complex sensorless speed control, low electromagnetic interference. So, they are used in air conditioners, refrigerators, kitchen exhaust fans, industrial machines and so on. Okay. Wherever you have low power, single phase motors are used. They are used in instruments. Wherever you have small fans are there, they are single phase motors in the instruments also. For induction generators, the same thing works as generator. We have the grid connected generator and self-actuating generator. So, here leading wire is taken by capacitors. Okay. We will discuss in detail when we go into these machines. So, I am just giving you an overview of things, okay, today. It is not that you everything we go to details now. Okay. Right. Then they are brushless, induction brushless and compact, no synchronizing equipment and easy to manufacture, reduced cost. So, they are used in mini hydro, captive power generation, wind energy. Okay. For stepper motors, I mean this is a typical stepper motor construction as I told you. So, it moves in steps as you excite these things. Okay. Then this is a toothed rotor. So, you can see the steps is variable direction. So, it moves in steps like this and this is a toothed stator. So, you have different windings here. So, you go on exciting different windings. So, the magnetic field is produced and this goes inside this. Have you got an idea how the stepper motor, broadly it is the construction feature of the stepper motor. Of course, the feature stepper motors are, they are used for cruise control, automotive gauges, then computer drives, printers, medical and scientific instrumentation. Okay. Then switched reluctance motors, you switch again a stepper motor which is switched, okay, in a high speed. You can say it is a high speed, while stepper motor mostly a servo drive, switched reluctance motor is a energy converter. Okay. They are used in centrifuges, washing machines, small appliances and fans. So, low construction complexity, sensorless operation, high speed operation possible and high startup torque is possible. So, these are some of the features. I am just quickly going through the different type of machines and their features and applications. Okay. So, this is you know, you can say this is the rotor of a SRM, okay, this is stator. Okay, this is a single phase motor. This is a squirrel cage. This is squirrel cage, okay. This is stator of a, so a two winding stator of a single phase motor. This is a switched reluctance motor stator. So, this will work in as a SRM, okay. This is basically a single phase induction motor. For linear motors, as I already explained, is basically unrolled one, which is basically you use a typical formula. Force is given by I into current, I into B, I cross B is the force. This is the magnetic field. Okay, most common type of operation, Lorentz actuator. Okay, so linear motors are highly controllable acceleration, high power converter linear motion. You have high power is possible. And where are they used? Linear motors, magnetically levitated trains. So, what you can do is you can lift the train, you can have an aircraft on the ground. Okay. So, maglevs are, they are not on the ground, they are lifted by a small, by a magnetic levitation. Now, they are using superconductors also, some of these things. So, the whole thing is on the top, then you have a linear motion to go for the movement and you can have very high accelerations. And the speeds which are achieved are nearly about 500 kilometers per hour. Speeds of the maglev trains are so called, they name it differently, there are bullet trains, magnet trains. So, Japan, they are used, they have a few places they are used basically from airport to some of the neighboring places. So, it is very specific this thing. For India also they were thinking of bullet trains and maglev trains, but I think now they seems to have just be slow on it because of the cost and complexity involved in this. They were thinking of having from Delhi to Agra or something like that. Okay. there are a lot of demand. Somebody says Chennai to Coimbatore. Every chief minister started asking, then I think they must have given up this thing. So, there are lifting mechanism in mines, you can linear motors are can, and hypervelocity weapons like electromagnetic guns and spacecraft propulsions, okay. They are suitable for this. Okay. So, I will quickly just next 2 minutes show you some of the typical examples of these special machines. Okay. And this is a robot, industrial robot. See, these are the motors here. So, there is a motor here. Okay. There is a motor here, there is a motor here, and there is a motor here, and there is a motor here. This is industrial robot. In fact, it should be other way around. So, it can lift, okay. It can operate at different angles. So, the many of these motors are permanent magnet motors, servo motor. Okay. So, you can see each of these motors can make, this motor can tilt in one direction, okay, and there can be a motion here, okay, and there could be tilting here through these motors, and there could be tilting here through these motors. Okay. So, this motor will make an angle like this, this motor, and this motor will again tilt, you make this angles like this, and this motor may facilitate this, and this motor will tilt like this, and this motor like this. So, this is an industrial robot. Okay. Can you imagine how it can be done? And there is a milling machine, this is a machine tool application, there is a permanent magnet motor here and a stepper motor here. Okay. So, you can move the, you can do the milling, okay. You can tool, you just cut it here. So, by this movement it can do a lateral movement, and this one can change the tools and so on. Okay. So, machine tools, both a combination of PM machines and stepper motors are used. Okay. Then renewable energy, I mean this is a PV panel. Okay. Now, this PV panel maybe an inverter, so it will operate this motor, okay, which will work as a pump, and then it will pump up water. So you can have a deep well pump through operated by a PV panel, okay, solar energy. This is one typical application, of course, with this converter here. Okay. This is one a laboratory model of a PV operated pump, okay. And of course, in the laboratory, you know, they are projecting the light through these bulbs, okay, on these panels. Okay. I hope you are seeing these panels, right. And then you have the pumps is pumping water here. Okay. This water is pumped like this. Okay. For this, we got a this is a setup in a very good PV lab in we got it near Sydney, New South Wales University. Okay. They have this system. Okay. So, they want to collaborate with India on this thing. Okay. So, you can, this is one of the things. Okay. And this is a wind system. So, the wind generator, they have induction generator, this is the induction generator, and this is the gear system. Okay. So, as it rotates, so this goes to, so this is the induction generator. So, grid current induction generator wind system. Okay. And this is a one of systems installed in India, is in Karnataka, Chitradurga. You can see the large number of windmills. They are all supplied by GE, and so they are typically 1 megawatt each type of capacities. So, I just thought it will sensitize you on each one will have induction generators, and they are connected to these substations which are located here. Okay. You see these strategic substations. Okay. This is a engine driven induction, single phase induction generator which was developed. This is induction generator, okay, which was designed, which we have it in our lab. Okay. So, but some more work need to be done. Okay. This is a self-phase induction generator, because this has been patented. It is a special design, okay, which is there. Okay. This is a picohydal system. Picohydal, we say, but less than 10 kilowatt. And this was again based on our technology, which develops SCIG, self-phase generator. This is the SCIG, self-phase induction generator. And you know, this is the turbine, and there is a belt and water is entering through this. Okay. This is installed in one of the sites, and this is used as a dump load for excess load of this one. Okay. Because we developed this again another view of the turbine and generator. Okay. So, this is the generator and this is the turbine. Okay. Then this is the controller which was developed by us, and this is need to be perfected, and this has been put it in the field. Okay. We will discuss it when we go to the this thing. Then automobiles, you know, this is what is inside an automobile. You have a transmission gear, then this is the machine here. This is the rotor and stator assembly, automobile, and it goes inside the flexible plate and so on. Okay. And this is a electrical network inside an automobile. So, you have a generator here, electric machine, and this is a inverter rectifier system. So, you have a 42 volts DC bus, and you have DC-DC converter, and you have 14 volt DC bus. And they use an initial starter, 12 volt battery, 12 volt load, AC loads, etcetera. Okay. Now, they are all loads, the 42 volts also DC-DC converter, 36 volt battery, 36 volt loads, DC AC load. So, in a car, many loads are there, you know, they go some operate 42 volts, some 14 volt, and there is a generator which will be operated on that. This is what is a Lendl machine or a dual field. This is a like a typical synchronous machine, stator laminated stock, and this is a claw pole. This is a slip through slip rings you pass the DC current, and this goes inside. So, it is a synchronous generator, but the field system is little different than the conventional multipole system. You can see this is a car in which so many motors are there for various applications. Okay. You can imagine. So, there are air conditioning, antenna lift motor, seat actuator motor, fuel pump motor, window lift motor, CD shuttle motor, door lock motor, tailgate motor, rear wiper window motor, okay, sunroof motor, you know, defrogger and windshield washer pump. Okay. You can see so many motors are there in a car, okay, with so many applications, you know, throttle controls, radiator, heat light, headlight and mirror remote control, windshield controls and so on. So, it is just to sensitize you, so many motors are there in a to do so many operations, and future may be even more. Okay. This is the maglev which was in Shanghai. It is between Pudong airport to one of the suburban terminals. This is the maglev motor, magnetic levitated one. And last slide I will show you, this is inside of that train. Okay. And at this point when I took the photograph, this was running at 389 kilometers per hour. That is the speed in which it was running at that point. Okay. So, people were not vibrating, quite smooth ride. So, I think it is, you must understand, 389 kilometers is not a small speed. You know, aircraft's normal speed is 700 kilometers per hour, most of the aircrafts. So, you can see that this is what is being produced. Okay. So, we will close it here. This idea was just to give an overview of the special machines and their possible applications. I am sure this will go into making the quality of life of the people better. Okay. So, from next lecture, we will go deep into each of these machines and do it. So, we will close it here. Thank you.